What will Baidu AI bring to the world? Your voice can wake up more devices and operate machines. A connected road network where every car understands road conditions. The driver's time and hands will both be freed. Faster diagnosis of diseases and a shorter development cycle for new medications. Striving for longer lives. Smarter public systems, operating intelligently according to the tide of people stream. Cities that are instinctively aware of you and cooperate with you. We make data, algorithms, and computing power open. Whether a large enterprise or an individual, everyone is capable of creating more. With AI together, we can help more people. Together, bring history to life. And together, learn how to steer the future. Baidu.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome Dr. Chi Lu, Vice Chairman, Group President, and COO of Baidu.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you all for joining us for the first ever Baidu World at Las Vegas. We're really excited about the opportunity today to tell you the latest AI innovation, to unveil new platform, new products, but more importantly, I want to tell you how we at Baidu are accelerating the pace of innovation at the China speed, and how through open platforms, we can all work together to change the world and make it a better place. As we all know, the AI era has already arrived. It will be the center of driving the fourth industrial revolution. It will have deep and profound socio-economic impact. The reason why AI has unprecedented power is because the fundamental nature of AI technology. At its very core, AI technology are systems that are built from hardware, software, and algorithms. But the most important thing is these systems have the capability to automatically learn and acquire knowledge from data and apply those knowledge to solve problems, to achieve goals towards the outcome we want. Knowledge is power, and this is powerful because with knowledge, we can solve any problems that are of high value to us. And to drive more and faster AI innovation, data will play an essential role. Data is the carrier of knowledge. Without data, you cannot build a system that can understand natural language conversation. And only with a lot of data can we build a system that can recognize all objects on the road. And we can apply that for autonomous driving, for example. Therefore, capturing and harnessing more data would be a deciding factor for how fast AI innovation can go. And this is why AI has already been applied across a wide spectrum, and data is the catalyst for transforming and elevating existing industries and creating powerful new ones. And this is also why China plus AI is a special macro structure that has the potential to drive more and faster AI innovation. And there's a structural reason for that. As we all know, the tech industry requires a set of structural pillars to enable, to drive talent, capital, technology, and the market. Historically, the United States is the only country that has all of those. Now, China has all those as well. Now, in terms of technology and talent, at the top tier, the United States is still by far the best. However, the gap between China and the United States are closing, and they're closing fast. And what will give an edge to China is a much larger population and a fast-growing market, and favorable policy environment that are designed to nurture and enable more data harnessing and AI innovation. Now, to begin with, China has a lot more data for AI innovation. For data about people, China has a population of 1.38 billion people. There are more than 1.1 billion smartphone users. The online population is over 750 million, all in a single market. For any AI innovation that matters to people, healthcare, education, there's just a lot more data for people to try new ideas, more ideas, and at a faster pace. Now, for data about industry, China has the largest manufacturing and traditional industry base. For the auto industry alone, there are more than 200 million vehicles, over 200 OEMs. Again, there's a lot more data to harness and to drive innovation. Now, in order to harness data, drive innovation, it requires infrastructure and a friendly policy environment to enable. China as a nation is fully embracing AI. The Chinese government understands what AI can do, and they show a lot of commitment for sustained and long-term investment. AI is part of China's national five-year plan. And just a few months ago, the Chinese government published a comprehensive white paper to call out a systematic investment in AI. And they also pay attention to policy. They have policies that support national AI platforms. They have policies that are designed to enable more autonomous driving development. Overall, you put everything together, China plus AI is a macro environment that is in a strong position to drive more and faster AI innovation. And that's just great news, great opportunity for all of us around the world. Because now, in addition to the United States, China, Chinese companies can contribute more. Because AI does not have any border. Technology innovation benefits everyone. Whenever there is a new cancer treatment that's discovered, it saves lives everywhere. Anytime a new learning method is found, it helps everyone to become better. For all those of us working in Chinese tech companies, working on AI, we want to embrace this opportunity to innovate, to drive innovations so that we can better serve everybody of the world, change the world, make it a better place. And that's exactly what's motivating all of us, any one of us at Baidu, driving us working so hard with so much energy to accelerate the pace of innovation. Now, let me give you a quick overview about Baidu. The simple way to think about it is Baidu is essentially the Google of China. And because of our search engine heritage, just like Google, Baidu is by far the best, most powerful AI company. Baidu has the the leading AI technology, the best overall AI talent, and a vast amount of data assets that come from a leading suite of online services. And Baidu AI has been developing at a very fast pace over the many years. Baidu is among the very first to create a deep learning institute in 2013. In 2014, we create Silicon Valley Labs and the Baidu Research Labs. In 2015, Baidu again is among the first to launch a conversational AI platform. And also, in 2016, we debuted self-driving technologies and the Baidu Brain AI platform. 2017, last year, we pivoted the entire company towards AI. We unleashed a large number of AI initiatives. Especially, we launched the Apollo autonomous open platforms for autonomous vehicle, for autonomous driving. Now, going forward, Baidu is an AI company. AI is at the center that drives everything we do. First, we're going to use AI to transform and elevate our today's core business. Search, personalized feed recommendation in Mobile Baidu, and video and entertainment for iQIYI. For those of you who do not know, iQIYI is essentially the equivalent of China's Netflix and a lot more. Baidu owns iQIYI as a wholly owned subsidiary. So we're going to transform and drive the current set of core business using AI. And more importantly, we're going to use AI to build a number of new businesses, especially through Apollo platform, the autonomous driving business, and using DuerOS, the conversational AI platform. These are two leading frontiers of driving AI technology. And economically, they have huge opportunities for Baidu to grow into, and at the same time, they fully leverage Baidu's core strengths and the core capabilities. And underneath, we use a common set of technology platforms, Baidu Brain and the Baidu Intelligent Cloud, to drive all those product and business initiatives. Speaking of Baidu Brain, this is clearly the most complete AI platform in China. At the infrastructure layer, over the many years, again, because of search engine heritage, we have built up a strong set of cloud capabilities, and we are in position to drive a lot of innovation from hardware to software and hardware in the future of cloud. We're very, very strong. And next layer, Baidu has a substantial set of data assets and a strong data capabilities as well. And up the stack, the AI computation engine, Baidu has a strong suite of algorithmic capabilities. And we also provide very, very powerful deep learning framework, deep learning platforms, both in the cloud and on the device side. And then further up, we have cleanly separate two layers of capabilities, the perceptive layers and the cognition layers. And each layer provides a powerful suite of APIs. So put it all together in terms of technical strengths and the platform capability, Baidu Brain absolutely can rival the best of the world. It's getting stronger and stronger. It is fully capable of supporting and enabling and unleashing a vast number of AI innovations at a rapid pace. And as a matter of fact, Baidu Brain, as of today, is already the most vibrant AI platform in China. Look at these numbers. Our developer community is growing so fast, and our platform activities, these are the daily call volumes, over 280 billion calls per day. These are massive, massive numbers. And the variety, the speed of all those different types of AI applications, AI innovations, AI devices are blossoming. First party, third party, the amount of speed of innovation is simply amazing in the Baidu ecosystem. And that is what it's all about. It's all about productizing commercializing AI technology so that they can make a difference in people's lives. They can make the world a better place. And that's today's core agenda for Baidu World. Our core agenda is going to unveil new platforms and new products. They represent the latest of productization and commercialization of Baidu AI technologies. And we're going to focus on the Apollo autonomous driving platforms and all the products built on top of that, and the DuerOS conversational AI platform, and all the devices that we innovate. And these two are absolutely the frontier of driving AI technology today, not only because of the technical capabilities, but the huge economic potentials ahead. If you walk around the CES, you will absolutely see these are the two frontiers. And we're going to focus on that. To begin with, we're going to unveil a major new platform upgrade today for Apollo. We're going to launch Apollo 2.0. Now, let me give you a quick overview about Apollo. Apollo is the world's first and largest open platforms for autonomous driving. We launched Apollo on July 5th last year. Within short span times, it's growing super, super fast. And for Apollo, we designed and architected the entire platform and ecosystem based on a set of fundamental principles. And these principles capture the core essence of how AI technology will propel the auto industry towards the future of autonomous driving. And these principles are designed in a way that they endure. They can withstand the test of time. As a matter of fact, we published an Apollo manifesto. And these are the four founding principles of Apollo. First is open capability. We're going to open all our technical capabilities for autonomous driving to all our partners. And this is a huge critical catalyst for China's auto industry to move from today towards the future of autonomy. Because the China auto market is highly fragmented. There's over 200 OEMs. None of the single ones is capable and should do everything by themselves. Open capability is a key catalyst. Second is shared resources, especially precious resources such as data. Our platforms can use Apollo. Our partners can use Apollo. But every partner also has the opportunity to contribute. But the design principle for our ecosystem is the more you contribute, the even more you will get from the ecosystem so that every partner can benefit more and more as they contribute to help them accelerate the pace of innovation, to differentiate their product. Accelerate pace of innovation is essential for the ecosystem. And we're going to provide a fundamental set of core technical capabilities, such as a very, very powerful, massive simulation engine. And the simulation engine will be able to harness more and more data that enable every partner, every developer within the ecosystem to innovate at the increasing pace of innovation. Last, the most important is sustained win-win. Apollo is designed with a simple and healthy business model. And we have sustained the win-win relationship with all our partners. It is these principles that puts together a vibrant, vibrant ecosystem. The inception of this ecosystem was less than a year ago, as you can see on this time chart. Honest to God, the pace of innovation, the growth, exceeded our wildest imagination. It is growing so fast. Again, I said we launched Apollo 1.0 on July 5th, and then we kept our promise. We're iterating our platform super, super fast. We launched Apollo 1.5 in September. In November, we launched Apollo Pilot. This is a very, very important thing I'll talk about later. Apollo Pilot is the acceleration of productization of the platforms. We're putting together more and more powerful solutions, packaged scenario, to enable our partners to build commercial-ready autonomous product vehicles. And today, we launched Apollo 2.0. And thanks to all our developers, all our partners, our developer community is thriving. Look at these numbers. Over 8,000 developers, over 90 developer partners, more than 50 committed development plans. And starting from today, we're going to give a whole lot more capabilities, unprecedented set of capabilities. Simply put, today, we're going to give each of our developers, every of our partners, the capability of autonomous driving on simple urban road. And to tell you a lot more about it, please join me. Welcome Mr. Wang Jingao. Jingao is the head of Apollo development teams. Please welcome Jingao.
Thank you, Qi. Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Jingao. I'm really excited today to tell you more about the latest of Apollo development. Apollo 2.0 is one giant leap into the future of autonomous driving. I'm not only talking about what we have done, what's new, what we are going to do next, but also I will share with you how partners and the developers around the world, like you, use Apollo open platform to get a jump start of their own autonomous driving project. As Qi just mentioned, Apollo was announced in April last year. For the past 8 months, we released Apollo 1.0 in July and Apollo 1.5 in September. Since the very beginning, Apollo gathered tremendous momentum. But what makes us even more excited is the overwhelmed community support around the globe. For the past 6 months, Apollo became the most vibrant open autonomous driving platform worldwide. For every week, there is more than 150 commits to the code, and over 1,800 developers has forked and used our code. And just in 6 months, over 165,000 lines of code opened in GitHub. Today, we are really pleased to announce Apollo 2.0. It's a significant milestone for Apollo with the autonomous driving capability on simple urban road condition. It's a giant leap because it's opened the door for commercialization of autonomous driving. Apollo 2.0 is the best Apollo released ever. Next, I will walk you through four major updates: complete solution, security debut, enhanced capability, and optimized simulation service of Apollo 2.0. First, Apollo 2.0 is a complete solution, and it's open. All the modules are available for the very first time. As many you already know, Apollo is a flexible architecture with four layers. The bottom layer is vehicle reference layer, and on top of it is a hardware reference layer with computing unit and the sensors. And on top of it is open source platform layer, and on the top is cloud service, such high definition map and the simulation. And today we're releasing all the modules of each IMA layer. And by releasing all the modules, can give partners an overview and a better understanding of our entire architecture, and to better integrate Apollo in their own system. Apollo is open source part, can be freely used, and the open capability part can be accessed easily through our open API. And what's more, Apollo open part segmentation is under Apache 2 license, which means it's open and it remains open. Next big update is Apollo security solution, which provides a full lifecycle security solution for connected vehicles. It has security and OTA update service, which is only allowed authorized and protected data to access vehicle. And in the middle, it has IDPS and on-vehicle firewall, which is keep monitoring incoming traffic and preventing the abnormal network behavior. And there is a Apollo black box, and which is include software and hardware to do safe storage and transmission for large amount of data set, which can help us to access the root cause of abnormal event, and also to accelerate the product reliability. One reason why Apollo is so developer friendly is we keep elevating every existing model at a very fast pace. Next, let me pick three modules, give you an example. The first is localization. As we all know, precise localization matters. During Apollo 1.0 demo in July, we tried to bring our CEO Robin to the front door of National Convention Center, but we can't, because Apollo 1.0 localization is specially designed for open space. The high-rise building and the glass wall make localization unreliable. In Apollo 2.0, we solved this problem by using adaptive fusion LiDAR, GPS, and IMU. It can achieve state-of-the-art accuracy of 5 to 10 centimeters, even in urban canyons and tunnels. Apollo 2.0 localization module is always accurate, no matter the place. Planning and control is another big area receive lots of enhancement. The cutting-edge planning can handle intersections, left turns, right turns, even U-turns, and the changing lanes, and observe traffic flow and the driving behavior. The adaptive MPC control module makes the ride much faster and smoother. We host an Apollo 2.0 test ride for our media friends a couple days ago in our Sunnyvale office. One journalist, after she read, she told me, if we haven't had any conversation, the ride is boring. There is no difference from a human driver. Boring, I think that's the best compliment we get. Perception model also receives lots of updates, and it can see further and know more. We add cameras to do real-time signal light detection with over 99% accuracy and up to 500 feet. And the sensor fusion will enable us see objects clear and further. And in Apollo 2.0, Apollo simulation is now faster and better than ever before. Prior Apollo 2.0, if developer want to use Apollo simulation service, they need to compile and upload the complete Docker to the cloud. It takes at least 30 minutes. In our Apollo new simulation service, you can just simply provide the link of your GitHub, and you are ready to go. It's reduced the setup time from 30 minutes to 30 seconds, 60 times faster. And not only quicker, it has a lot of very powerful new features, such as actual road scenarios such as one-click cloud debugging, lots of new features. And we do have Apollo 2.0 simulation live demo in our CES booth. I highly recommend everyone try it out and see how powerful it is yourself. Put all the things together, Apollo 2.0 can perform day and night autonomous driving capabilities on simple, ordinary road. And it started from China and expands to the world at the top speed. Now Apollo 2.0 is not only running in our locations in San Jose and Beijing. It also runs at Peoria, Illinois, the headquarters of our partner, Autom Staff. Next, let me show you a video of to see how Autom Staff to upgrade to Apollo 2.0 just in a week in Peoria, Illinois. Let's roll the video.
My name is Bobby Hambrick, and I'm the CEO and founder of Autonomous Stuff. We supply products, engineering services, and state-of-the-art software to help enable autonomous driving. Our headquarters is based in Morton, Illinois, because the Midwestern culture is very hardworking and also very loyal. Baidu is a pioneer in AI technology. They created an initiative called Apollo. It's an open, reliable, and secure software stack for autonomous driving. Now, Apollo is announcing the release of Apollo 2.0.
I'm Josh Whitley. I'm the lead software engineer here at Autonomous Stuff. Apollo 2.0, we have cameras being added to the system. They can do stopping based on objects in front of the vehicle. They can follow at a set distance, stoplight detection.
You recognize when the cars are passing by, they're classified as cars. You recognize pedestrians, you recognize bicycles. When the light turns green, it negotiates the intersections and then moves on.
They've brought perception online faster than anyone else I've seen. You only have two eyes and you can only look in one direction. An autonomous vehicle is always looking in every direction at the same time.
Our goal together is to deploy fleets of vehicles to help change the way humans move from point to point. Just call the app, the car comes and picks you up, it's running Apollo software and it takes you to the next point. So it's our goal to help enable that to happen as soon as possible.
Thank you. And from the video, you can see how our partners, Autonomous Staff, enjoy the newly released Apollo 2.0 capability. And today, we are very pleased to have Bobby, the CEO from Autonomous Staff, and Joshua, the leading engineer of Autonomous Staff, at today's conference. Let's welcome Bobby and Josh. Thanks, Bobby. Thanks, Josh. And I highly encourage all the partners and the developers to check out the new features of Apollo 2.0 and make your own vehicle up and running at your own location. Releasing Apollo 2.0 feels like a moment in history, but what we are really more excited is about the possibility Apollo 2.0 bring to the community. The participating from partners really speed up the innovation. And today we are very happy to say all the four major computing platforms, Intel's, NVIDIA, NXP, and Renesas, are supported by Apollo platform. And from the partners, we all know, we hear that we want the Apollo platform support more vehicles to provide a low-cost sensor solution, to support QNX, to provide a high-definition map globally. And we hear that it's our top priority. It will deliver those solutions in the future. To speed up global autonomous driving commercialization, we released Apollo Pilot, which is an integrated solution for productization of autonomous driving. Come with leading partners, I will show you how Apollo Pilot provides fast productization for passenger vehicles, for minibus, and for transportation service. Apollo Pilot is working with Chery to enable level 3 autonomous driving for mass production in 2020. Next, let's see a video of how Apollo and Chery work together. Please roll the video. Thank you. And not only for passenger vehicle, Apollo Pilot also work with Kinlong, the second largest commercial vehicle OEM in China, to deliver closed venue mini shuttle bus for volume production this year. Next, let's see a video. Please play the video. We are really excited about this collaboration and really looking forward to see the volume production of this minibus in this year. Not only in China, but Apollo Pilot help global partners in many ways. Apollo is team up with Access LA and the Lily System to enable the pilot project for next generation paratransit service in Los Angeles. Access LA is the second largest paratransit agency in the United States, and it provides over 3.7 million paratransit trips for disability and the senior community in Los Angeles every year. And together, we will provide autonomous driving paratransit service to overcome the driver shortage, to improve the quality of service, to reduce the operation cost, and ultimately, to enable mobility for people who cannot drive by themselves. Apollo 2.0 is a significant milestone for Apollo. is phenomenal. We are thrilled about it and hope you do too. Apollo is created by Baidu, but not for Baidu. It's for all the partners and the developers who want to use this transformative technology to reinvent the mobility experience for human beings. We truly believe together we will change the world at an accelerated pace. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Jingao. Thank you so much for all our wonderful partners that made Apollo 2.0 possible. So Apollo 2.0 is such a monumental step forward. It elevates the Apollo ecosystem to a complete new level. There's two key takeaways for you. First is unprecedented capabilities for autonomous driving on simple urban road conditions for the first time ever, available for every developers or our partners. Doing this kind of capability for yourself is one thing. Making that available for everyone is completely different. We're super proud of what we have done, and we're excited about what could be when the community is coming together. Takeaway number two is the acceleration of commercialization and productization of the Apollo platform, particularly in the form of Apollo Pilot. In a nutshell, we're seeing more and more commercially viable scenarios and capabilities that are packaged into solutions and made available to our partners. And this began a new phase of the Apollo ecosystem, which is the beginning of rapid commercial production of Apollo-powered autonomous vehicle. On this slide is, as of today, we have partners with four committed plans to have commercially available vehicle for autonomous driving. First is later this year, we have L4 minibus available commercially. And in 2019 and 2020, there's three partners. These three are all well-established Chinese auto OEMs. They've been in business for a long time. And we have three vehicles that will be available for volume production. This is simply amazing. This is the China speed that we talked about. Because if you ask the question, when will L3, L4 vehicles be commercially viable and ready on the market? If you ask these questions less than a year ago, nobody would have believed it would be this early and with this much variety. And this shows the power of the open platform. And this shows the platforms operating in a macro structure that speeds up innovation. Because every day, and I've talked to so many partners and developers, every day we're seeing new innovation signals. And every day we're discovering new productization, new commercialization possibilities. Let me give you one example. For example, L4, the vehicle has no wheels, human cannot control. We thought it's a long time to come. No, because all it takes is for it to think about at the lower speed, in a more constrained environment, what are the scenarios that are viable, customer willing to pay for. All of a sudden, the door opens. There's so much more opportunities. And this is only the beginning. There's a lot more to come. The speed of productization and the commercialization is going to accelerate. And the speed also comes from many different factors. At this early stage, to commercialize autonomous driving, policy innovation is fundamentally important. Policy innovation plays just as important a role as technology innovation. And the policy innovation is designed as an important part of Apollo ecosystem from the get-go. We have been actively working with a number of important municipal government in China to design and roll out more and more policies that will unleash the speed of innovation and the rate of commercialization. For example, just a while ago, the city of Beijing issued a new policy to make it easier for autonomous driving. And the city of Baoding and city of Xiong'an, they joined Apollo as strategic partners working with us closely. As a matter of fact, the city of Baoding just released a new policy a few days ago to make it easier for us to innovate together. And the city of Xiong'an will play a huge role for years to come because Xiong'an is the next mega city. It's being built from ground up. It will be bigger than Shenzhen, bigger than a lot of cities in the world. And it is designed to unlock technology innovation for the long term, for the long term. President Xi personally paid attention to this design to last 1,000 years. And we're working with the city of Xiong'an very, very closely to design and innovate the future urban infrastructure, the future urban transportation policies, so that in the future, autonomous driving is built in for the long term. The significant cannot be understated. Policy innovation, technology innovation, they go hand in hand. They must move in unison at this stage to unleash more and more innovations. And with Apollo 2.0, it also puts the ecosystem in action and on the move, because we are working with so many partners actually building commercial product. Every day there's vehicles being developed, tested, operated across a growing list of cities in China and the United States. This picture on the wall is a snapshot taken today. And that snapshot is a first fleet of autonomous vehicles. And they are all future commercial product. And they are all powered by the same open platform. And this lineup is impressive because here you got the first L4 minibus, and around here you have several versions of L3 passenger sedans with different type of configuration, different type of sensors, many different variety of choices for differentiations. And over there, you have a L4 street sweepers. And there's another L4 logistic delivery vehicles. There's a large variety already. And most importantly, they can all be in action today. They can all drive themselves. Now, we're going to try something that's never done before. For the first time, we're going to have a live parade of a fleet of autonomous vehicles. They're all powered by the same platform. And I'm going to connect through a live video stream to my team's colleagues at Baidu campus in Beijing. It is very early morning hour over there. Freezing cold. But we're going to see a live parade for the first time of autonomous vehicles. My colleague Tao Ji will run the show. Tao Ji, please take it away.
Hello, everyone. I'm Tao Ji, Baidu Self-Driving Car Project Director. Now it's Beijing time, 6:53 in the morning, and we are here at Baidu's headquarters in Beijing. Today, we are going to see a range of self-driving vehicles being presented in the parade, including sedans, minibus, street sweepers, and a very cute delivery robot. All of them are built upon Apollo platform, an autonomous driving system that has been designed to satisfy different user needs under different circumstances. Now let's connect with my colleagues Xiaofan and Wuming, who are in the sedan and minibus right now. Let's have them tell us how it feels.
Hello, everyone. This is Xiaofan. I'm an engineer of Baidu's autonomous vehicle program. Currently, I'm sitting in an autonomous sedan. I will show you how it works automatically. As you see, I was sitting in an autonomous sedan. As you see, the car is driving automatically. As you see, the car is driving across the yard to my desk. Now the car is switching to the U-turn lane. The steering wheel is turning automatically, like an invisible man is driving the car. The whole ride is quite smooth and stable. I'm quite enjoying the experience. Now we are driving back to the autonomous vehicle station. Let's get back to Wuming.
Thank you, Xiaofan, and hello everyone in Vegas. I'm Wuming, the project manager from Baidu. Now we are sitting in a minibus. The name of the minibus is Apollo. The unique part of the minibus is there is no steering wheel and the vehicle is driving by itself. Even with 7 people in the vehicle, it's still quite roomy and also comfortable. By the way, the volume production of the vehicle will be in this year. Now we are going to park here and let's move outside. It's quite cold here in Beijing. I just ordered something warm. I guess that is my delivery. Buddy, thank you very much for the delivery, especially in such a very cold morning. With a warm scarf, now I feel much better. Well, besides the lovely self-delivery robot, over there, we have another autonomous driving vehicle. The self-driving sweeper could clean the street by itself. Actually, we already have several of this kind of vehicle operating every day in Beijing Olympic Park from September last year. Back to you, Tao Ji.
Thank you, Xiaofan and Wuming. Qi, back to you.
Thank you, Tao Ji. Let's give a big hand to the amazing engineers. They are amazing, and big hand to all our partners who make it possible for today's first ever live parade of autonomous vehicles. And this is what China Speed actually look like. And this is only the beginning. The speed is going to only accelerate with many, many factors driving forward. And the one thing for me to call here is that just a couple months ago, the Chinese government named Apollo its national autonomous driving AI platform. This puts us at a completely different spot. We are now called the national teams, just like a soccer team. We're at the national team. What you just saw was a parade of the first ever national team autonomous vehicles. And this gives us so much more opportunities, so much more inbound interest. And we are really thrilled and looking forward to work with more and more partners to drive a whole lot more innovation together. Now, speaking of drive more innovations, particularly with accelerated pace of innovations, the most important factor, the most precious aspect is people. Baidu is very, very motivated to work with more and more partners to democratize AI technology, to make it available for more and more people, more and more developers, so that there's more talent to join the innovation, to drive faster pace for AI to change the world. And there's no better people to talk about this than my next distinguished guest speaker. And he is the godfather of modern autonomous driving technology. And this is Dr. Sebastian Sloan. Please join me. Welcome, Sebastian.
Thank you, Chi. It's been amazing to see this amount of progress in that short a time. I've been playing with self-driving cars for almost 15 years. And I can tell you for about 30 of these 15 years, people would smile. And it's only the last year. It works actually better than most microphones. And seeing this amazing progress around the world is mind-blowing. I can't wait until traffic becomes safe and useful for all of us, including our children, our aging population, our blind people, everybody. Now, I'm here as a founder and president of Udacity to announce a collaboration with Baidu that I'm very proud of in the area of education. As she pointed out, there is a very small number of experts in the world that can program AI or self-driving cars. And about 7 years ago, I decided to found a company, almost like a university of Silicon Valley, to teach people tech skills so that we, the people, are ready for the next decade and the next century. So today, we are announcing a partnership with Baidu. It's not our first Chinese partnership, but it's certainly a highly exciting partnership. We will be, for the first time, build courses together with a Chinese company and an American company. If you look at the landscape of AI, she pointed out correctly, it's the fourth industrial revolution. And the vision of AI is that we can take anything repetitive we do today, from driving cars, to medical work, to office work, to what lawyers do, and have machines pick this up from us and do the work for us. But according to the New York Times, there's only 10,000 experts in the world who are able to build these devices. There's 1.34 billion people in China. There's over 7 billion people in the world. And the number of people who have the appropriate skills to build this technology is vanishingly small. At Udacity, we've decided to partner with the world's best companies like Baidu, many companies in Silicon Valley, like Google and Amazon and Facebook, and now Baidu, as the essentially the Google of China, to really give people a chance on the table and learn those skills. We have, I think, upwards of 9 million enrolled students in the world. About a fifth of those now come from China. China's our fastest growing segment. There's an enormous thirst for education. And we teach students in the world things like self-driving cars. We have actually multiple programs where we teach students self-driving cars. Many of the graduates have made it into Baidu as employees. Udacity alone teaches more students self-driving cars than all universities in the world combined at this point. See, this works. We are extremely proud and extremely delighted to work with Baidu on Apollo 2.0. Not just on the technology, on growing better and better algorithms, but on the people side. Teaching people Apollo and having students in the world be able to contribute. There's a saying, if you catch a man a fish, he has dinner for the night. And to be correct, I'd say if you catch a woman a fish, she has dinner for the night. But if you teach a man or a woman how to fish, then they have dinner for the rest of their lives. So this is all about scale, about speed, about amplification, about changing the world of transportation globally using the Apollo platform in collaboration with Baidu. So we are extremely delighted today to be on stage here. I want to thank you for being invited and announcing a very new collaboration for us, hopefully a first step in many steps. But we will be launching as a free set of courses, Education for Apollo. So anybody who wants to further themselves, contribute, and use Apollo can come to Baidu and to us and learn those skills free of charge. We'll support the simulation. We support the entire software so you can learn wherever you live and whatever you do. As long as you have internet connectivity, you don't pay us a dime, you can learn about Apollo. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Sebastian, for this wonderful, wonderful partnership. We are really, really looking forward to working together to really democratizing AI technology, make more talent to be able to join the innovation. Now, speaking of talent, I would be remiss not to pay tribute to the amazing talent, the wonderful employees of Baidu. It is their passion, their hard work, their 9 days hours that made all these innovation possible. Next, let's take a look at how people at Baidu pursue the big AI dream. Let's roll the video. This is what looks like to innovate on AI at China speed. Baidu itself is very much an AI innovation lab. For all of us at Baidu, we live in the breeze of AI every day. When I first joined Baidu about less than a year, just about 1 year ago, first day go to work, there's no badge. It's all face recognition based. Then you can use face recognition to pay for at the vending machines and at the cafeteria. The list goes on. Baidu is absolutely an AI innovation that's on the move. Next, I'm going to unveil a new set of products on a different platform, just as important, just as potent. It's the DuerOS conversational AI platform. Let me first give you the business and the strategic context. Now, historically, any platforms that is able to unleash a new wave of interaction modality will unlock a huge amount of economic values. For example, Microsoft Windows, they got the mice and the keyboard right, and they built an amazing franchise, wonderful company. Apple, they got the finger and touch right. Now, they're the largest company of the world. And we believe voice and natural language is a much bigger opportunity. And we believe Baidu is best positioned to get that right for China and more. And we're going to focus on smart home in particular. For smart home, device is the new app, and platform is the key enabler. And driving innovation at China speed is everything we do. To tell you more about it, please join me. Welcome Eric Jing. He is the lead of DuerOS platform. Welcome, Eric.
Thank you, Chi. Hello, everybody. So I'm Eric Jing, Jing Kun. I'm from Baidu. So today, I'm very happy to introduce Baidu DuerOS to all of you to explain how we plan to enable devices with voice capabilities, how we put intelligence in everything. And to help you understand, Baidu DuerOS is Alexa of China, and much more than that. As she mentioned, China has structural advantage in the AI era. So China has more than 400 million households, 200 million cars, and more than 1.1 billion phones. So per IDC report, by 2020, that 27% of smart home and 51% of car, 68% of smartphone and wearable, they will have voice capabilities. And China is a huge market to drive innovations. So after we launched DuerOS, the platform also has a lot of achievements. So we now have more than 130 partners. And those partners are actually cover each device scenarios. Let me give you some examples. For instance, for the phone scenario, we are partnered with Vivo, Huawei, Xiaomi, and many top phone makers to enable their phone has voice assistant capability. We are working with TCL, Skywatch, and many smart TV makers to enable their smart TV to be more smarter, can be voice controlled. We are working with Harman, Haier, Meidi, and many famous companies to ship more voice-enabled devices to the market. From the hardware solution perspective, we have more than 20 hardware solutions. Each hardware solution can be very easily ported to our partner devices to enable those devices have voice conversation capabilities. For each month, we have more than 5 new products released to market, and we have received overwhelming positive feedback from our partners. The product allowed by our users. The platform is growing at a tremendous in China at China speed. So if we look at those numbers are month over month growth rate after we release. So in terms of the install base, month over month growth rate, we have more than 148% growth rate. And for the monthly active device, the growth rate is more than 127. So the platform growing at China speed. So DuerOS is the clear leader in China. It's the most vibrant AI ecosystem in China. Not only we have device partners, we also have chip makers, we have system integrators, we have content providers, we have developer platform to working with us. And as a platform, we are super happy to enable our partners to continue evolve, continue iterate, innovate at China speed. And from the platform perspective, we released DuerOS in public to public last year, July, with three-layer architecture, which includes the intelligent device platform, the DuerOS core conversational system, and also the DuerOS bot platform. Each layer actually includes multiple, many components. Just 4 months later, at the Baidu World Conference, we announced DuerOS 2.0. It actually has many new and upgraded components. So it's amazing to see a platform like this large get two major updates within 1 year. So DuerOS devices, now they are already everywhere, either in the morning or at work, or on the road, or back home. You can interact with different DuerOS-enabled devices. So next, I'm going to show you a video how people, a family of three, 24 hours, how they interact with DuerOS-enabled devices, how those devices are actually improving, enhancing our daily lives. Let's play the video.
Hey,
小杜小杜,
现在北京时间 7点整, 公司服务1811行动计划。哎呀，吃饱了，小度小度。嗯。今天路况怎么样？路况畅通。
帮我发动车子，空调开到25度。在线宝贝儿，小度小度，帮我导航到公司。啊，对，顺便路过一下加油站。好的。
妈妈，我想吃披萨。
好嘞，小度小度，给我经常去的那家披萨店打电话。
小度，我想跟爸爸视频。嘿，宝贝儿。妈妈今天晚上要来听这个故事，知道吗？好的。我做的披萨。嗯。回家了。那萌总找到人喽。哎，爸，你好。现在我们坐。最左边的那个男生是谁？高奋七，中国内地男演员。小度，小度，我还想听说说那个故事。
白雪公主每天都把这个小木屋打扫得非常干净。
小度小度，关灯。So as you see, those are the real product that you can buy from the market. So DuerOS devices are already used everywhere. So, like in the video, in the morning, you can tell DuerOS-powered smart speaker. You can even talk to DuerOS-powered smart mirror. And at work, you can use DuerOS-powered smartphone. And on the road, when you are driving, you can talk to DuerOS-powered car. If you take public transportation, you can talk to DuerOS-powered earphone. And when you're back home, you can talk to DuerOS-powered smart TV. And all those DuerOS-powered smart devices, they are all connected. There is a case in the video, you probably noticed. I can ask the smart speaker to turn on the air condition in my car. So those devices are across our daily life scenarios. So we have seen so many product innovations in our system. So this is only a snapshot of some of the product on the platform. By working with our partners for quite a long time, we have been very impressed by the innovative spirit from our partners. So this is an example that 2 months ago at Baidu World Conference, by working closely with Raven team, we are announcing the Baidu first party smart speaker. This speaker, as you can see, is a very beautiful speaker. It's co-designed with Teenage Engineering, a very famous Sweden company. As you can see, the smart speaker, there are a lot of product innovations. So for the smart speaker, it actually has two modules. So one is the base, and the other one is the touchpad. User can place the touchpad in different angles. And they can even take it off, and it can work standalone by single tap. And the base can work standalone too, and those two modules can also work very seamlessly together. It's a very innovative product. And today, you can go to the website raventech.cn to buy one device for you. On the same day, we release Raven R, a smart family robot. There is a shared module between Raven R and Raven H. It's the touchpad. So if you place the touchpad on Raven R, it behaves like this. It's kind of an experience that you've never seen before. It behaves as your friend, as your personal assistant to you, to your family. So for Raven R, it's also available this year. So besides the product I mentioned before, those products are already released to market. Today, on this stage, I'm also very happy to announce 3 new, very innovative products that build on top of DuerOS. So we have been working with Low team for some time. And I believe each of the category, each of the product actually pushing the product boundary in each category. They are all very innovative. So without further ado, let's see the first one. For the first one, I believe that many of you are smart speaker users. That one top use case for smart speaker is actually to control the smart home devices. The top used smart home device is a lamp. So every day, user talk to smart speaker, they turn off the light or turn on the light. As we ship smart speaker, we also receive user feedbacks. A lot of users sending feedback to us saying, why I need to buy two separate devices, even at a higher price? Why I need to manually pair them and learn how to control them? Is there any way to combine them together? Here's the answer. We are announcing the Sunlight Smart Lamp Speaker. Sunlight, as you know, is an industry that they have been the lighting industry for 20 years. Their business has spanned over 15 countries and regions. It's the only company that won CES Innovation Award and Honor Award in the last 3 years. And for this product, at the base, this is a smart speaker. And most importantly, this part is a smart lamp. So how it works? It's two-in-one device. It actually has several lighting modes. It has reading light mode. It has night mode. It has different mode for hours for home scenarios. And it has 16 million color configurations, can respond to music. If we ask the device to play some music, the color will change by following the sound rhythm. Definitely, it's integrated with DuerOS 2.0. So you can control the device by voice. It gets full access to all DuerOS content. So for this Sunlight product, it will firstly available in China market, April this year. And this is the first product, Sunlight Smart Lamp Speaker. So now I'm going to introduce the second product. For the second product, as some of you may know, that last year also at CES, we announced deep collaboration with XiaoYuZaiJia Little Fish. And we released this product, Little Fish Smart Robot. We won some awards. It was selected as one of 14 coolest tech products by CNN last year. And it actually set a role model for multimodal interactions by leveraging the microarray, speaker, screen, and camera. We are very happy to see, after we released this product, that a lot of other companies, they are following the same trend. So last year, we see Echo Spot, Echo Show, and I guarantee that this year, we will see many other similar products. But for us and the XiaoYuZaiJia collaboration, the innovation never stops. It's actually accelerating at China speed, from hardware to AI to the content. So next, I'm going to invite Clement Song, who is the founder and CEO of XiaoYuZaiJia, on stage to introduce the new product to you guys. Let's welcome Clement.
It's great to be back again. And we pioneered the screen-based conversational computer, and we launched our first product in 2015. And since then, we have seen many companies following suit in this direction. Since our launch in China, our Little Fish home robot has been really well received. Products are being actively used almost daily by families in over 696 cities across 48 countries. and expanding quickly. You must be curious who they are. In China, a lot of the young parents, they have to leave their kids and parents behind to work in big cities. They're busy, and they're really not there for their families, unfortunately. So little fish open up a new door. Through this door, parents can drop in on their kids. They can check in on their parents who might be living alone. And in my case, my mom used little fish to video chat with my daughter, who is 7, to help her with her homework almost every single day. To my mom, it's a magical experience. She never has to call me and try to arrange a time to do a FaceTime with her anymore. Having a fixed portal to home lowered the barrier of communication and forever changed the way families connect. We believe tens of millions of families can benefit from the experience in China and worldwide. Since our launch of the DuerOS conversational capabilities, we have seen growing demands from our users to ask the robot to do other things, playing the videos, playing music, setting alarms, and search for things. For a lot of the seniors in the families, we realize that voice commands are not just a convenient way for them to interact with the computer, but the only way they can use a computer. So Little Fish opens up a new world to them. There's so much we can do. We constantly take feedback from our users, and we're innovating nonstop, and we're getting better nonstop. And today, I'm very happy to announce our next product, Little Fish VS1 Smart Video Speaker. We have completely redesigned the product, both hardware and software, for a much better voice-first interaction experience and a much better content discovery experience. And we have a little video for you. So let's roll the video, please.
You can't see the future using only words. There should be a process of acquiring wisdom. She'll expand your perception, not limit it. And create a more genuine experience to give warmth when you communicate. She can let you accompany your children with one click and enable them to see the world. Make the words of any sentence instantly visible. For life skills, it's better to see once than hear 100 times. Open your eyes, reconnect with the world. You can hear the future as well as see the future. See us, see the future. Little Fish at Home VS1 Intelligent Video Speaker.
Thank you. We spent months developing the color fabrics, and it's really paying off. I really like the green one. It matches the green sofa in my living room. And my mom would love the red one. So for VS1, we have added the 6 microphone array so that it can actually enable a much better far-field voice command experience. And we have carefully calibrated and tuned the speaker so that it can deliver a great music playing and video playing experience. And at the same time, a much clearer communication experience. VS1 continue to deliver and support the multi-party video chat. And the drop-in feature we invented, and people loved. So now you can control those features through voice. VS1 also serves as the one-stop video and photo store for your family. All the family members can share their videos and photos through their Little Fish app. And we not only just want to be the store, help you store, but also want to help you remind you of those treasured moments of your life. So with the support of the DuerOS 2.0, Now we have added over 30 new, very useful skills, all leveraging the strengths of Baidu. Baidu Maps, Baidu Knowledge Graphs, Baidu Search, and the iQIYI video libraries. And we're regularly adding new skills. And as we grow the platform, we hope that more developers will join us and help us develop the home ecosystem together. Last but not least, with an optional Little Fish TV cast dongle, VS1 instantly transforms into a voice-controlled TV set-top box. And this opens up a new world of opportunities. Just imagine transforming your living room into a home karaoke, a personal gym, and a home school. And there's much more. I'll be sharing more details in our upcoming March launch event in Beijing. And our product will also be available in March. Please go to zaijia.com and we'll send out more information about our launch event and the pre-order policies. And thank you very much. Enjoy CES and hope to see you in March. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Clement. So it's a great partnership, and it's a great product. Cannot wait to see, cannot wait to get it 2 months later. So as you see, the first two products we reviewed are both targeted China market. DuerOS is a clear leader in China. It's the most vibrant AI ecosystem in China. But DuerOS is also beyond China. So we want to lead the product innovation. We want to set an example for the world, for the globe. So the third product is targeting to Japan market. So as some of you visit Japan before, so those are the typical Japanese apartments. And unlike US big house, big apartment, so those are the typical Japanese apartment. They tend to be smaller. Those are the bedrooms. They tend to be smaller because very high housing price. And the majority of Japanese citizens in big cities, they rent apartment for living. There's one common thing in those two pictures. In the bedroom, you see, there's no TV. There's no big screen. Why is that? TV is too big for them to install in a small bedroom and very hard to move when you switch apartment. But actually, there is a strong need in Japan to get a big screen experience, get immersive video experience, to how to address that concern. Our answer is, we are announcing popping Aladdin projector lamp. So what's a projector lamp? You may wonder. It's a projector, and it's also a lamp. So the idea was from Popin, a famous Baidu Japan subsidiary brand. The team came up with this idea and working very closely with Jimmy, who is a very famous leading smart projector company in China, came up this projector lamp. Next, I'm going to show you a video to explain how this product works. Let's play the video. So that's a projector lamp. It's turning the bedroom into a big entertainment space. So as we all know, the best position for a projector is actually at the ceiling. This is a unique part of Japan. So if you see this picture, this is a standard interface at the ceiling for every Japanese apartment. It's mandatory by the government. So users can install this device very simply by themselves. They just hold it by simple twist. It's offsite. They have a big screen in the apartment. And it's also combined with the lamp, which is the most used home device. But after setting up the device, you can basically control the device by using voice. You can search for content. You can search for educational content. You can play music. You can do different things with DuerOS support. It's a very innovative product. And this product is already on Kickstarter and receive overwhelming positive feedbacks. So for this product, it also will be available this year, July, and firstly available in Japan market. So those are the three new products that we want to show you today. They are Sunlight Smart Lamp Speaker, VS1 Smart Video Speaker, and Pop-in Aladdin Projector Lamp. In addition to those three products, and all the products I show you in the video today, you can all go to our booth. We have a beautiful booth and have all those real products. You can try the product. You can experience how you can control those products and using voice. We are, as a platform, we are truly impressed by the innovative spirit from our partners. That's why we want to, on this stage, to show the product innovations to offer you to the world. And in the meantime, we want to invite more partners to our platform. We want to enable you to have a smart device experience, to have a better product, and to evolve, continue iterate at China speed. So I'm very looking forward to collaborating with more partners to create a smarter future. Thank you, guys.
Thank you very much, Eric, for showing us the wonderful set of new product innovations. And also thank you for the DuerOS platform team for taking a big, big step of moving beyond China, taking Baidu AI innovation beyond China into the world, in Japan as first market. But we can do a lot more because we have powerful platforms at Baidu and are working under the macro China plus AI environment that gives us better speed, the China speed. And we will do more. We'll innovate more, lead more, and drive more innovation to serve more people of the world. So therefore, going forward, global platforms will become more important part of what we do. DuerOS is already made a first step. DuerOS will be a lot more global. And we're going to announce a set of initiatives today that Apollo will be global in a big way. To tell about the details, I'm going to invite Mr. Zhang Yaqing, who is the president of Baidu. And among his many, many responsibilities, Yaqing is also responsible for Baidu Global. So please join me, welcome Yaqing, to tell you more about Apollo and DuerOS Global Partnership.
Thank you. Thank you, Chi. That was amazing. It's just hard to believe. But a year ago, most of this was still on the paper. It's a concept. And now it's coming to reality. Just amazing to see just strong momentum of Apollo, with DuerOS, and also the rich set of products by our partners. And Chi mentioned, we are the national team for autonomous driving, just like the national soccer team. I would rather to be the national ping pong team. It is critical for us to work together. And partnership is the lifeblood of Baidu. Our business model is to make sure we work with partners. Without partner, nothing would happen. So let me just spend in the next 5 or 10 minutes to go through some of the key partnerships. But if you look at AI, it's what Baidu is all about. Now, AI is the most significant transformative force of our time. It is hard to imagine any industry that's not going to be touched by AI at all. And also, AI is borderless. It transcends any company, any nation. And we need to work together globally. And this requires a lot of work. Large companies, startups, academia, research institutes, policymakers, regulators, and we need a collective wisdom and a partnership. And Baidu is a strong advocate and a champion for openness and globalization. There are a lot of partnerships. In the previous sessions, we talked a lot already. And it is hard to enumerate all the partnerships. So let me just highlight a few examples. And of course, I'd like to announce 2 very exciting new initiatives that will come after. And the first, we work with Qualcomm. Qualcomm, obviously, is a leader in mobile and silicon. And so we put DuerOS on Snapdragon. So instantly, smartphones, IoT devices become voice-enabled. We work with Microsoft. Microsoft is a leader in cloud computing. Azure has the most extensive global coverage and the footprint, and also with a rich set of features, security, and reliability. So Apollo work with Microsoft, and then, of course, all the software services will be accessible from everywhere in the world, customers, developers. And today, I'm very excited to announce the availability of Apollo 2.0 on Windows Azure. Actually, goes live today as we speak. I want to thank the team because they really worked very hard, actually, over Christmas to make this happen. We also work with TomTom. TomTom, of course, is a leader in global mapping in the services. So whether it's DuerOS or Apollo, we need a global mapping coverage. So this, we join force with TomTom to making sure all our customers, the devices, the products, can go global with high definition location mapping and the production capability. There are a lot of partnerships. And today, I'm very, very happy, excited to announce 2 new major global initiatives. The first, in fact, we just signed this MOU a few moments ago, about 2 hours ago. We are forming Apollo Southeast Asia together with Asia Mobility Industries. It's a leading company based in Singapore. With the support of Singapore government, the Economic Development Board, the Spring, and also the Land Transportation Authority. So this will be the first Apollo commercial entity outside of China with a $200 million investment. And we are launching Apollo Global Institute. AI is about data, it's about technology, and it's more about people. So this is a new institute that we're going to perform research, recruit talents, and serve our customers globally. So the research will be focusing on, of course, technologies like sensing and control, HMI, V2X, but also on issues like policies and regulations and the system level technologies. And we will have the institute initially in Silicon Valley, Seattle, and Beijing, of course, and we're adding Singapore to this list. Now is the most exciting time. I'd like to invite our Apollo global partners on the stage. Of course, we have a lot of partners. It's impossible to invite everybody. And we have a few representatives from those companies. I'd like them to invite them. So let us welcome Mr. Yu Dongchen, who's president of Bosch China. Sebastian Thoron, founder of Udacity. Kevin Dallas, corporate vice president of Microsoft. Kendrick Miller, senior vice president of MXP. James Zhang, president of China and the global vice president from NVIDIA. William Strimbosch, head of autonomous driving and the vice president from TomTom. And also, Qi Zhengyu. Zhengyu is the vice president of Baidu's autonomous driving. So he's behind, or he's the overall champion of all these efforts you have heard about Apollo. And also Robin Wu is the vice president of Baidu's also autonomous driving, among other things. And he's more from the business perspective.
Kevin,
that's you. All right, so let us just... All right, this is Microsoft, Kevin. All right, let us put our finger here. Okay, 3, 2, 1. All right. Congratulations.
Thank you.
All right, let's just...
Let's all come... First of all, huge thanks for all our global partners. Let's all come to the front of the stage so that we can have a group photo together.
Let's
have a group photo.
Yeah.
And
you are too tall.
I'm trying to click. And let's have photos first. And hopefully the clicker will work.
So my job is easy, just smile.
Okay, let me also bring this wonderful event to the end. It's so clear that AI is changing the world in a massive way. And let's work together in partnership. Let's all leverage the speed of innovation, tap into the China speed. Let's all change the world, make it better for everyone. And thank you, everyone in the audience, for attending this first ever Baidu World in Las Vegas. Let's all work together, and we'll see you next year at CES. Thank you again. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.